Hey guys, this is Abhishek from gadgetsreviews.com and today we are here at the NDTV studio with Rajiv Makhani. He is a well-known gadget guru, we all know him. And he has just started his new show which is called Tech Grandmaster 3. This is the third season of this show. So we are going to ask him some questions that what can we expect in this particular new show.
Absolutely.
Welcome Rajiv.
Good to see you and very happy to be here. Hi to everybody, you're here with me on the Chroma Tech Grandmaster Season 3 set. 2 years we've already done this, and the best part of all of this has been that every year it's all grown bigger and bigger and bigger. Of course, lots of questions which I'll try and get into right away.
So there are not lots of questions, but again there are a few questions. First of all, how do you describe the Tech Grandmasters 3 this time?
So you know, the difference is, like I said, every year it grows bigger. So we started off first year, there were approximately 200 to 300 teams that participated. Second year we went to about 450. This year, 900 teams from across the country participated and took place in this online test. From that we got down to the last 30, 32. And it's been growing bigger and bigger and bigger. Today, whenever we go out, I go to schools, I go to colleges, people meet me from corporates. The big question that they have is, when is Tech Grandmaster starting again? And I think because the interesting part about this is it's a quiz show that is more a game than really a quiz show. You've got to have technology knowledge, but you also have a lot of strategy. There are mini games that you play. So it's not just a dry, tell me the inventor of, and what is this device, and who invented this, and what is this technology. There's a lot of fun within the show, and I have a lot of fun hosting, which is why I keep coming back every year and doing it.
Okay, so when you talk about the target audience, what kind of audience, in what age group you actually see those people will get the maximum benefit out of the show?
It's a very good question. You know, so a lot of people ask me, it's a tech quiz show, and I say no, it's a life quiz show, because today, what is life without technology? Today, 5 or 6 years back, the people who talked to me and my audience for even a Gadget Guru, any of the other shows that I used to do, used to be called techs, nerds, geeks, you know. You've been called those things also. Today, even within your own audience, who's your audience? Everybody. Who doesn't have a mobile phone today? Who doesn't want a tablet? Who's not looking for a digital camera? Who's not thinking, what could be my next laptop? Especially the mobile phone has made everybody a techie. Everybody has an opinion. Everybody thinks that it's brought them closer to the world of technology. Today, when I'm at an airport and I'm at a mall, I'm eating somewhere and people come up and start talking to me, there are 73-year-old grandmothers and 9-year-old from schools. And that's really my audience, which is why this is schools, colleges, corporates. Everybody, and the questions that we have are the kind that almost everybody sitting at home, especially sitting at home, people will say, oh, I think I know, I absolutely know. They'll get it before the contestants, or they'll be very intrigued by saying, wow, I didn't know that, but that's a wonderful thing to know. So like I said, these are not dry, boring questions about technology. These are questions for everybody. Answers that are the kind that will make somebody's jaw drop, and somebody will feel really good because they knew more than the contestants. It's a quiz and game show for everybody.
So when we talk about Tech Grandmaster 3, how is this show going to be different from the other tech quiz show which we see on TV channels?
Well, first and foremost, I haven't really seen a tech quiz show anywhere. Not in the country, and I've seen one or two abroad that were terrible. I mean, they were exactly what I was describing. Boring, geeky, nerdy. Tell me the inventor of this in 1841. Who made the locomotive? Who cares? It's not a history lesson. This is about us today. There's social networking. There is a lot of things that we do from popular culture, pop culture that we call it. This is what we do on a daily basis. This is what we're exposed to on a daily basis. Why is tech to do with who invented the transistor or the microprocessor? Do we really all care? If you really want to know about it, Google it. We don't want to tell you that. We're not here to make you more educated about things that you anyway find boring. We want to talk about things that are exciting and things that you, at the end of this show, should sit down and say, I didn't know those five things, I want to know more. I want people to go back to an internet search engine and say, I want to know more about it because that was so interesting, right? And frankly speaking, I think we're the only tech quiz game show in the world. So I don't know who to compare to.
Okay. So when we talk about the audience, the people who are kind of active these days when it comes to tech, we see a lot of people who are active online,
right?
When it comes to social media, when it comes to social
platforms
like Facebook Facebook and Twitter. So how do you plan to make this show interactive and reach that kind of audience in some way possible?
Again, a good question. So one, we have a viewer question. You can win big prizes within the show. The second is, we have a lot of online activity that takes the same thing forward. There are a lot of things.
Is that related to the show?
Yes, it's completely and totally related to the show. So things about the show, some very interesting questions where the questions will be asked, but the answers will only come when you actually watch the show, and vice versa. Many things that I'll ask on the show, which will only be revealed on Twitter and Facebook. So there's like a 360 degree around the whole show, and you're totally right. If you're not online, you're dead, right? And that's what the show also is all about.
Okay. So when we talk about the timing of the show, if someone is going to miss the show in some way possible, maybe he's busy somewhere else, can he also
watch it
the repeat?
Absolutely.
Like, what is the timing and all?
So NDTV Good Times. So the show comes on Saturdays and Sundays, 7:30. And repeating it again, first airing Saturday and Sunday every week, 7:30 p.m. on NDTV Good Times. But it's also available online. So the minute the show is done out here, there will be repeats on television also, but you can also catch it online on NDTV Good Times, the website, as well as NDTV Tech. So enough places for you to catch it. And if you're not following the path and the journey of your favorite teams, remember, the big differentiator and something that always has most people very intrigued is, how can a school, two school kids, take on people from Google? How can modern school Barakamba play against Microsoft? This actually is the real essence of the show, that if you're interested in technology, and like I said, who isn't, then it doesn't matter whether you're 14 or you're 27 or you're 35 years old. It doesn't matter if you work for Microsoft or you're in some school. This show proves every single time that tech is the winner, not a school or a college or a corporate. There's nothing more interesting than to see a school child, a school kid, defeat a corporate, right? Or vice versa, but usually school kids are much faster nowadays.
So can we also expect some other kind of audience apart from the school's children over here in the show, especially those who might be interested a lot more about tech? But they may be in college, they may be corporate.
So that's what I said. So the teams are school teams, there are colleges, and there are corporates.
Okay.
So the teams are not just school.
Okay.
The teams that play here, for instance, we've been playing out here for a while. We've had everybody. I mean, which team isn't here? Microsoft, Google, Amity School, law schools, Colliers, which is a marketing and a company like that, Accenture. Think of the top corporates in the country, think of the top colleges, St. Stephen's, DAV, everybody is here. We're talking about 900 teams that started off. So anybody and everybody is already here.
Thanks a lot for
Thank
your
you.
Time.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And of course, watch the show and tell us what you think. And watch the show and post all the comments on his website when you watch this, and tell him what you thought about our show. See you.